superposition theorem. The superposition theorem states that the overall response of when a circuit consists of more than one source, the overall response of the network is equal to the algebraic sum of the response of individual network. The other sources are kept. The other sources are kept inactive. This is the superposition theorem. So now, what is the question? Find. What is the question? Find the current flow. 2 + 8/2 using superposition theorem. Okay, using superposition theorem, you have to find the current flow 2 + 8/2. How many sources are here? Consider 50 ∠0° voltage source alone. Then redraw the circuit. Last row. Come this way. Redraw the circuit. What is V?
Voltage.
V is?
Voltage.
by Z, I is equal to V by Z. The V is 50 angle 0, then angle 50 angle 0, that is the imaginary part is 0, divided by Z. Z is these three are connected in series, isn't it? Then 2 plus, that is J4 plus 2 plus J5. This is equal to 50 by 2 plus J9. What about I? 1.17 minus 5.29. This is I answer. The question is find out the current. Yeah. You have to consider here, we are considering the 50 volt source alone. So this is considered as I1. It is not the current flow, that is.
Current through this one. This current source
all, let us it is considered as one source, isn't it? It is our impedance, isn't it? Am I right? This is impedance. Then this is one reactive inductance. Then these two are in A, the containing series are in parallel. Then I can redraw the circuit like this, isn't it? I can redraw this one like this.
Voltage source alone. Then
So for to make this current flow inactive, I am going to open circuit. Then open circuit and I am going to draw the circuit diagram as it is. Now what is our question? Find out the current flow this one. So this circuit consists of a single loop, isn't it? Single loop. V is known and Z is known. Then I is equal to V by Z. V is given and Z is this three. Then we are going to find I one. This I one represents. We are going to consider the first source, only the first source alone. Please, I want to name it for them. You are going to considering by considering the first source, the current flows through this impedance. Then the next one, removing this one, this one becomes inactive, and you are going to keeping this one. Then at what condition this one become inactive? Short circuit. Voltage equal zero under short circuit condition. So redraw the same circuit. This one alone becomes short circuited. Then the question is find out the current through this one. There is no change. Now in this case itself, we are going to find out the current through this one. Then some methods are used. Yeah, here the current source. Suppose if it is a voltage source, we are going to consider these two are in loop. Mesh analysis is easy, isn't it? It is easy by doing the mesh analysis. Then the current is this minus this. Put it on the yeah. But here the current source is given. Then again, each and every problem has some trick. Meena, apa think panna? Current division technique method. These two are in parallel, so automatically total current is known. Then it is easy to apply current division technique to find out it. That is also the valuable one, but it takes some time. So this is the once you get an idea about it, you can solve the problem easily. That method is also right, but it takes some time and it becomes a tedious one. So this is you are this is the node. We know the current in here. And these two are in parallel. Then when I this is the node, total current. This current is divided into two parts. These two are in parallel. Once I know the total current, I am able to find I1 and I2 by using current division technique. These two are in parallel. And once you know the current of this one, total current, the total current value theory of Veena, you can use this method. That is total current into, or suppose if I want to find out the current I1, I1 a if I want to find out the current through the resistance vein of Veena, you know the total current. I mean, so many methods are there, but it is also one of the method because you know the total current. But you do not know the I1 I2 தெரியாது but you know என்ன தெரியும் I total current is known. Then I1 is equal to total current into opposite resistance. The resistance suppose it is a 5 ohm, it is 10 ohm, opposite I1 கண்டுபிடிக்கிறோம். The opposite resistance value is 5 ohm. Opposite resistance divided by sum of the resistance, then it is 15. If you understand, in the same way, you know total current and find out the current through this one, I2. What about it? I into total current into opposite resistance. You know the opposite resistance in that? The I2 is opposite resistance in that? 10. I2 into I2 is equal to total current I. I value suppose n amps na total current 10 into then opposite resistance is 10 divided by sum of the resistance. Okay, wow. The same method here I am going to use. Total current into opposite resistance divided by sum of the resistance. This is I2. Now the question is using superposition theorem find out the current through 5 ohms. This I2 represents considering this source alone. This I1 represents considering this source alone. What about the overall response?
I
total is equal to I1 plus I2. 0.03
and then minus
58.9. Check whether you all get this correct. Check your answer.